Bristol Community College, Mathematics with Dan Avedikian, Math 131, Elements of College Mathematics, Section 5.1, Problem 3. This is Problem 3 from Section 5.1. It says, find the final amount for $1,200 invested at 12% compounded monthly for 12 years. Now, if you notice, this is very similar to number 2, except it has compound interest instead of simple interest, and that's what makes it sort of an interesting problem. So what's the difference, compound interest and simple interest? Now this one says compounded monthly, so that's telling me I have to use the compound interest formula, which is A equals P times 1 plus R over M to the M times T power, where M is the type of compounding, number of times compounded per year. So A, which is the final amount, equals P, the principal or initial investment, which is $1,200, just like the previous problem. Very different formula, though. 1 plus R, the rate as a decimal. So again, the rate is 12%, so as a decimal, it's 0.12. That's important. Over M, the number of times compounded per year. So for monthly compounding, M is 12, because it's 12 months in a year. And then close the parentheses, there's an exponent of m times t. So again, m is the number of times compounded per year, so that's 12, times t, the number of years, the time in years, so that's 12 years. So this is how the formula fills in. So now we'll just take it a step at a time until we get to the end. So any type of math you want to do, you work in parentheses first. So let's start that. So A equals 1,200. Times 1 plus, now I have a division in my parentheses, 0.12 divided by 12, that's 0.01. And again, if you want to do that on your calculator, enter 0.12, divide by, put in 12, and it'll tell you it's this. The exponent, 12 times 12, is 144. And I can complete the work in parentheses, just add the 1 and the 0.01. Obviously, that's going to be 1.01. So at this point now, what I need to do is that exponent of 144. I have 1,200 times 1.01 to the 144th power. You have to do the exponent before you do the multiply. That's extremely important. That's the order of operations that changes the answer completely. So to do 1.01 to the 144th power, you definitely need to do it with a calculator. And it's not 1.01 times 144. It's 1.01 times 1.01 times 1.01, et cetera, 144 times. Now that I can't even begin to estimate without a calculator. So let me do that, and the answer I'm going to get, you're going to have A equals 1,200 times whatever the result of that big, huge exponent is. So with my calculator, I'm going to put in the base of 1.01, use my exponent button, which on this calculator looks like that. It's an x with a little superscript of a y. Some calculators, it's what they call a caret. It looks like an arrow pointing up. Oops. So let me use my calculator to get that answer. So I'm going to enter 1.01, exponent button, 144 equals, and the answer is 4.19061554. I'll keep all the decimals for now. I'll round it in a minute. So I'll just leave that number on the screen, the 4.1906 whatever, and I'll multiply it times the 1,200 that I had written in front of the parentheses. And that'll give me the final answer. So the number that's on the screen now times the 1,200 that was in front of the parentheses. And the calculator says 5028.738712. Now, because this is money, I want to round to two places after the decimal point. I have 73, and then it's an 8 that's the third digit out. So that 8 is big enough to push this up to 74 cents. So my final answer will be $5,028.74. That's the final amount after investing $1,200 for 12 years at 12% compounded monthly. Now, just to make a comparison to question number two, if you remember the answer, it was a little under $3,000. It was like $2,900 and something. So the compound interest, instead of $2,900, or almost $3,000, you get a little over $5,000. So the compound interest does make a difference. And they're both 12%, they're both for 12 years.